Oh, do you want to kick us off, Mark? Thanks.
Afternoon, Manuel.
Good afternoon.
We'll start with the positive news. Your captain, Mark Noble, has signed a new contract, keeping him here until the summer of 2021. How positive is that for the club?
Yes, I think it's very positive for him and for the club. Mark is a player that played his complete career here when he was a young player. So I think that he deserves to finish his career also here. So very happy for him.
How much does he symbolise what West Ham is about as a club?
Well, he knew all about this club. That's why every time that he's talking in the dressing room, I think that it's important for new players that arrive to this club to know what is he, and he's always having that role as a leader. That's very important also in our team.
For you yourself as a manager, you've worked with some of the greatest midfielders in world football. Where does Mark Noble rank in some of those players you've worked with?
No, I don't think that is good to compare. Mark is a very important player here for West Ham. He has his career. And in every game, he demonstrates his commitment with this club.
What's his best quality, do you feel?
It's a good midfielder, it's a good technical player, it's a player that has a good view also of the complete pitch, and he has the personality always to ask for the ball.
One of the big talking points in the Premier League over the last week has been the racism that Raheem Sterling faced at Chelsea. For someone who knows Raheem well, you signed him at Manchester City in 2015. How hurt were you by those scenes at the bridge?
Well, yes, I read some things about that. I think that all things that damage the football. So I think that Raheem must be him very quiet. Just he talks already about that. And now I think it's better for him just to continue playing because he's doing very well and not have distraction about stupid things.
You know Raheem very well, having signed him. Will this affect him in any way at all?
All those things always affect a little bit, but I think now Raheem is more mature player. He has more, 2 or 3 years more when he arrived to Manchester City, so I hope that he will manage the situation in the best way.
You've managed all over the world. Is there still a huge problem of racism in football still?
No, I don't think that continue talking about that because maybe you give too much importance on small people that have stupid minds. So I think that everyone know that those people are not in the way the most of us think. So that's not important.
Looking ahead to the weekend, you're obviously in a great run of form at the moment. Things are going very well here at West Ham. How much are you enjoying watching your side at the moment?
Well, we are improving, without any doubt. The result says that we are improving, that we are scoring goals. It's not easy, especially in this team and this season, to win 3 games in a row and score in each game 3 goals. But that we must be very careful because things in football change with 2 or 3 balls, change absolutely the result. So we must continue working the same way we are doing now. In our worst moment, I always say the same. We are improving, we're in the correct way. Now we must try to keep these good results.
Collectively, you've obviously improved as a side, but how pleasing is it for you to see the team doing so well in an attacking sense as well, and like you say, scoring goals?
Well, was my mentality that I tried to bring here to this club, that you must try to score in every game as much goal as you can, and not because you score one, you must go all near your box to try to defend. I think that the players enjoy in the way we are doing, in the way we are playing. Now, I repeat, we must continue very, very balanced team in defending and attacking, because all is together, and a few mistakes that you are going to concede more goals, or a few options that you miss, you are not going to win the game. So I think that as a team, we are improving.
Up next, Fulham at the Cottage, up against the manager who's won the Premier League like yourself. What are your thoughts on the game?
Well, a difficult game, as always in the Premier League, especially that they are at the bottom of the table, as you said, with a new manager that has his career as a manager reflects what he is. Especially, I think that to win here the Premier League without Leicester is not something that you can do so often. So I hope that he will have a very successful job in Fulham after we finish this game.
in terms of your analysis of Fulham, how much have they changed since Ranieri has gone into the club?
Well, he's just starting his work. I think you cannot make an analysis in 2 or 3 games. So every manager needs time, and I hope that Claudio will improve this team.
When you look at this game, it forms the first of 5 matches against teams in the bottom half of the table. Could December be a real pivotal month for West Ham, and could you surge into the top 7 or 8 perhaps?
No, I answered last week that question, and I think that the most stupid thing that we can do is to believe that because you are playing against teams that are at the bottom of the table will be easy. We need to play against all these teams away in their own stadium. All the teams want to win points, especially teams that are in the relegation zone. So we must be very careful about that. We must be thinking game by game. We must play against Fulham, and are the 3 points more important, and I hope that we can do a good job and a good game.
When you look ahead to the game, obviously I know you've had a lot of injury concerns over the last few weeks. What's the very latest with your squad?
Well, I think that one of the merits of this team was to win the last 3 games having 6 or 7 players injured. We continue with the same amount of players. We know that we need to play a lot of games during December and January. So I hope that we will continue with the same spirit with the players that are able to do it.
What's the latest with Perez? He came off last week.
He has pain in his instep. We are reviewing here. Tomorrow we will know exactly which are the players that can be in the squad.
And Jack Wilshere?
Jack continue with his treatment in his ankle. He will not be involved in this game.
And Andy Carroll played 45 minutes last week. Again, another positive step for him.
Yes, of course. He first started the friendly game that we have played against Brentford. Now he played 45 minutes. He had the foul that allowed us to score the second goal. So he made a lot of good work for our team. We'll see what happened with him this week.
But it's positive that you're getting players coming back as well to create some competition for places.
Yes, of course, not only for competition for places, also because we don't have too many players. We cannot play with the same players all the games during this week. So every player that recovered from his injury, especially important player as Jack, as Andy Carroll, as you said, of course for us is very important.
Rhys Oxford has been in the headlines over the last 24 hours with a missing watch. Can you just clarify that situation? And has the watch been found? Is that situation been sorted?
Which situation, sorry?
Rhys.
Yes, which situation?
He's lost his watch at the training ground, been stolen, the police have been called in.
Rhys Oxford.
Yeah.
I read about that, but I really can't give you any more information.
Thank you.
Thank you, camera's off.